Hello guys, my name is Kiki and in this video I have something really cool for you. At least I am really excited about this, and it's not nothing else like a robot vacuum cleaner. It's an Ecovacs Deebot 901 version and I bought it on eBay as faulty. So in this video I'm going to try to repair this vacuum cleaner. I will be honest with you, I have never worked on a robot vacuum cleaner before, so it will be fun, most probably. I hope I can repair it. Let me show you at first the eBay listing. So this is it. As I told, this is an Ecovacs Deebot 901. So it's in German. So it's faulty and they expect it has a sensor problem. As you can see, I bought it. I was bidding on it and I bought it for 10 euro plus 8.5 euro shipping. So it was a pretty good deal. I thought it will be good for a video and it will be fun to work on. And let me show you the specification. So I will translate it for you. It means something like this is an Ecovacs Deebot 901. It kind of works up to a certain level. It's basically leaving the dock, but afterwards it's not able to orient itself or position itself in the room. And basically it's hitting the objects, it's crashing into objects, and they expect that it has some kind of sensor problem. So let me show you, let me put it on the dock, let me turn it on, and let me show you what it really does. Okay guys, so as you can see, I put it on the dock, I turned it on, there is a switch here, I already paired it to my tablet. Let's go enter to smart cleaning and let's hit start cleaning.
I'm starting the clean.
It starts perfectly. It's orienting itself at first and it starts. And as you can see on the tablet, it's already starting to register the area, and it already heated the dock, and it's just turning around. And again, as you can see, it's hitting everything. Sometimes it works pretty well, like now for example. Now it's pretty well. It works pretty well. Still okay. And now it's suffering again. It cannot turn around. It looks like one of the wheels are not turning at all. Sometimes it's either stuck or something like this. And you can see now it's stuck there basically. It cannot come out. So I will stop it. Ah, no, it's out. But again, it just goes into the wall. When it goes straight, it's quite okay. But when it has to change direction, then it's gone again. So I will just stop it and let's see what's going on.
Cleaning paused.
So I am back to the table. First, let me explain you how it works. Basically, there are quite a lot of sensors all around. The main sensor is this one here. I put it over. This one is called like a LiDAR or LDS sensor, and there are other sensors all around, like this bumper. On this bumper, there are four sensors in it. When it hits something, it's realizing it and it's turning around, it's reconfiguring itself. And there are also these sensors all around. At least these are against falling down, for example, on a staircase or something like this. So it works pretty well. And then there are the wheels. The two wheels are driving forward and backward, and this is controlling basically like it's a skid steered unit. And this front wheel is just it's not driven, it's just spinning as it needs to spin, and that's it. And there are some brushes we can remove now, we do not need this. And there is this main brush, and there is a vacuum there. And as you can see, I realized this wheel, this is turning hard. I mean, I can feel that the gearbox system in it, that it works perfectly. I drive the motor itself via the gears, but this one is just loose. I'm afraid we have an issue with the gears inside, and when it works, it's strange that when I pull it out slightly, and then sometimes it just stuck in a position, I know it's okay. So when it works perfectly, when it goes in a straight line, then most probably it's stuck on a good position, and then it works. But as soon as it's spinning it's turning left and right, it just gets loose. No, it's good, and it's loose again. So then it's not driving. This is which is causing it not to go in the right direction. So I assume we do not really have a sensor issue, but only a wheel issue. And I really hope I can repair this. I'm afraid that we have some broken gears inside. I assume there are plastic gears in it. And unfortunately, if this is true, then this will not be easy to repair it or replace it. Maybe if they are not extremely tiny or fine, then I can do something with my 3D printer to it. But I'm not sure. I have to look it online if I can buy, for example, an entire wheel system to it. But let's take it apart and let's get to it. And finally, it's off. It was not easy. I hope I did not broke anything. Okay, there is a cable here that I have to disconnect. Okay. So So, as you can see, this is the LiDAR system, the laser distance measurement system. There is a motor which is spinning this with a certain RPM, and this is basically how it's creating the map based on this. There are like these IR sensors. And one single PCB, and then one DC motor for the brush. I assume this is for the main brush, and these two are for the two side brushes, and these are the two wheel assemblies. This is the one which is wrong, so I have to remove this one. So let me check what else do I have to remove here to remove this motor assembly. I hope I do not have to take it fully apart. I can see here 1, 2, 3, 4 screws. I try to remove those and let's see if I will be able to remove them. The spring was flying away, luckily not into my eyes. But now, hopefully I am able to remove this cover and remove the motor. There is one power cable. This plus and the red and the black cable, and all the rest I assume is for the sensors. And there is one other cable going here somewhere, but I think I will be able to disassemble already this motor assembly, and if I do not have to replace it fully, then I will not need to disassemble it entirely to remove this one cable. I cannot really see where this cable goes. Oh, maybe it just goes to this. Yes. There is a micro switch here, which I assume is feeling if the wheel is changing angle. So for example, when you lift it up, then you get a message to your phone that the robot is lifted up. So I assume this micro switch is just sensing that. I cannot really remove it here, so okay. So at first I will clean it up, because there are really a hell amount of, I assume really this is cat hair here. I will clean it up because it's quite disgusting, to be honest. And then we will go further by taking it further apart. Now I cleaned it up. Kinda. So what is interesting, there is also I cannot lift it up, I don't know how well you can see it. There is this gear like something which is basically a rotation sensor. It's called, basically there is a hole sensor here, I assume this is a hole sensor, and it's detecting the spinning, the speed, the rotation, or the angular velocity, whatever you want, basically, of the motor, and from that basically they can calculate a lot of things, some distances and things like this. So let's take it apart and let's see where is our damage. Oh and yeah, this is what I'm afraid of. We have two dead gears here. Not even only one. There is one, this bigger one. Let me lift it up. Camera is not really catching up properly this wide, but as you can most probably see, I have a few missing gears here, and also on this small one there is one at least. And the problem that I think these are too small to be 3D printed on a FDM printer that I have. So I have to look around if I will be able to buy a whole assembly for this, because I'm pretty sure I will not be able to find just similar gears to it. Definitely not. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I will look for a whole gear assembly. I hope I will be able to find one, because otherwise I will not be able to repair this stuff. And then I will be back afterwards. So after roughly half a day I am back. I checked online the availability of the gear assembly, basically, or the wheel assembly, and I could find several versions, several options around 40 euro, so it's totally possible to replace it, but I thought I will give it a go and I will try to repair it with the help of my 3D printer. So as you can see, I already took it apart. Here are all the three gears that are inside. This one is absolutely intact. And these are the two. As you can see, a lot of tooth is missing here. And also here. And this is the other one. On this one, there are one missing tooth here. You cannot really see that well, but here there is definitely a missing tooth. So what I did, with the help of my caliper, I made some measurements, and with the help of Fusion 360 I remodeled two gears. And to be honest, I'm super happy how they turned out. I printed them with 0.1 millimeter layer thickness, and I printed them quite slow with 15 to 20 millimeter per second. And they look like they fit perfectly fine. So let's put it together. And let's see if it works. To be honest, I'm not 100% sure that these 3D printed parts will last for a long period of time, but at least I tried. At the moment, just to check if it's at all possible to print these, I printed them from PLA because this is the easiest to print with. And later on, if it does not work, if the from dimensional point of view it works, but the gears itself will not be strong enough, or they break or anything like this, then I will reprint it from nylon, for example, which is a way tougher material, slightly flexible, and it will not break. But as a first step, I will try. You can look at this closer. They are pretty nice. So let's try to put it together. So here is a small belt, and the first one is this smaller one, which goes here into the middle. And then now I have to put back this one. We have to put back the belt. And it's on. And as you can see, it's working nicely. On this one, I did not have to touch, did not have to do any modifications at all. On this one, I had to file down this surface a little bit because it was a little bit different in height than the other one, because it was not easy to measure exactly. So roughly, I had to remove a half a millimeter from the top part. And then the wheel goes through here. As you can see, it's going on to this shape. The shaft itself has such a shape. So I have to position it the right way and press it down. And there is a groove here on the shaft. And there is this ring. I do not know the English name of this. I have to just put it here onto the shaft. This is locking in place basically the wheel, so it does not allow. Oh, and it was flying away. So this ring basically is locking the wheel in place, and it does not allow the shaft and the wheel to fall off from the assembly. Okay. Now it fits perfectly. And it's spinning nicely. So as I told, I have no idea how long will this last. I have a lot of grease here, so I will distribute this along the gears. Okay, that should be good enough. Let's put it together and let's see if it works. It looks like it fits perfectly. Let's see if it's still spinning. And yes, it's spinning really easily. So you can see the wheel is spinning really so slowly now, but I can spin it extremely easily. So I think it should be fine. If I turn the wheel, you can see that the encoder is spinning nicely. I do not know how long will this last, but hopefully it will work for a time. Okay, let's put back the remaining screws. honest, I'm quite impressed with this vacuum cleaner, because everything is nicely cleanly routed, all the cables, there are a lot of places where you can clamp the cables, so they are not just all around. All the cables have its nice position. It works quite well. Okay, what is next? Okay guys, so I think I put it together properly, which is good news that no screws left. Basically it was not that difficult than I expected. So let's give it a test. Here we go to the living room, put it on the dock and I will turn it on and let's see how it works. Okay guys, so I put it back to the dock. Let's start it up.
I'm starting the clean.
As you can see now, it's turning perfectly, it's not touching everything, it's going nicely next to the wall. It's going around the dock. Now I will block its way. And it's creating the map. It's going nicely around the furnitures. No, next time it's not going next to the furniture, but one pass further. It's pretty cool. I'm pretty happy how it turned out. And now let's send him back to the docking station with this button. Return to dock. Recharging. And now he is returning to the dock. And it's docking. Okay guys, so as you can see now it works perfectly. I am pretty happy how it turned out. I hope you like this video. If yes, please don't forget to like the video. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And I hope I see you next time. Bye.